I think in part because clustering tends not to have one consistent definition. It's very algorithm driven. So there's different algorithms for doing clustering, and we can analyze each of those algorithms somewhat independently. There isn't really one problem, and then there's a bunch of different algorithms for attacking that one problem. Each algorithm kind of is its own problem. So I think the easiest way to go through and talk about unsupervised learning and clustering is to start going through some algorithms. So I'm going to start with single linkage clustering because I think it's in many ways the simplest and most natural.
Okay.
And it has some very nice properties. So it's not a terrible idea. It's been very useful in statistics for a very long time. So here's how single linkage clustering goes. Let's imagine we've got these objects that we'll call them these little red dots. We'll imagine that they're objects. And just because it would be hard to write down all the D values between them, let's just literally use the two-dimensional space, the distances on the slide here as the distances. Okay?
Okay.
So if you were asked to cluster this, how would you do it? Like, what do you think the groupings ought to be?
Well, just staring at them, there are either two or there are four.
Mm.
Or maybe there's five. So I would probably put the three on the left that are together. And I would put the four on the right that are together. Or I might notice that the two at the top of the ones on the right are more together than the other two and subdivide them some more. But if I were just far enough away, I would definitely say, so that seems like a reasonable clustering, but also the one that took all four of those and put them together is a reasonable cluster.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that sort of agrees with what my eyes are thinking as well. All right. So it'd be good if we could recover that kind of structure algorithmically. So let's talk through this algorithm. It's called single linkage clustering, sometimes SLC.
Or SLIC.
Ah, nice. It's a hierarchical agglomerative clustering algorithm, or HAC.
I like that acronym even better.
That's an Andrew Moore joke, for what it's worth.
Oh, it's a SLIC HAC.
Nice. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to consider each object a cluster to start. We're going to do this iteratively. So we start off with n objects, like we have here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we're going to define the intercluster distance as the distance between the closest two points in the two clusters. So in the beginning, all the points are in their own clusters. All the objects are in their own clusters. So the intercluster distance is exactly the inter-object distance. Okay?
Okay.
But little by little, we're going to actually be aggregating things into larger clusters, and we have to define what it means for how close is one cluster to another, and we'll say the closeness of between two clusters is the closeness of the closest two points between those two clusters. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to iterate. We're going to say merge the two closest clusters because, you know, they belong together, and then we're just going to repeat that n minus k times to leave us with k clusters. So k is now an input to this algorithm.
Okay.
All right, so help me out. Let's step through this. What would we merge first according to this algorithm?
Well, they're all their own cluster. According to my eyesight, which is of course perfect, I would take the two leftmost ones, upper leftmost ones, probably, and merge them together. They look closest to me.
All right, let me label them just to make your life a little bit easier.
Well, that'd be nice.
All right, so what do you think?
I would bring A and B together.
All right, they're now a cluster. So we had seven clusters, now we have six.
Okay.
Then we're trying to get, oh, by the way, we're trying to get down to two.
Okay. And then I would put C and D together.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Then I would probably want to put C, D, and E together because they're in alphabetical order.
All right, well, let's, just to be concrete about this, what is the next step that we're supposed to do? What we're supposed to do is say which pair of clusters is closest. And again, the distance between, say, I don't know, the AB cluster and the CD cluster is not the average over all the points or the furthest points, but the closest one. So, like, I think C and D, the distance between the AB cluster and the CD cluster is exactly the distance between B and D in this case. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
All right. So we want to know what's the currently closest pair of clusters.
Well, from where I'm looking, it's either E to C and D or G to A and B, and they look very similar to me.
E to C and D or G to B and A, is
yeah,
that what you said?
Probably G to B and A, staring at
I
it.
I tried really hard to make it so that there'd be an easy answer, but you're right. They're really close. So let's. I think it doesn't matter too much. We'll say that one's next.
Mm-hmm.
So now let's say, now we'll do a quick quiz.
Okay.
So what merge does single link clustering do next? Just give the pair of points that I would be connecting.
Okay.
Say separated by a comma.